there's the magic baby. What's up guys, today we'll be doing a review of the Xebec, I hope that's how you say it, tri-screen 2 monitor. Basically, it extends your computer, your main monitor, and it gives you 2 more monitors. I paid for this with my own money, so I will be giving you a very honest review, and it wasn't cheap, I will tell you that. First things first, you know the rule to my channel, when I drink, you drink. It does not have to be an alcoholic beverage. Mine will be. Today we are drinking more wine. Cheers. I'll be doing the review on both my MacBook Pro M1 and then also on my Dell PC. I don't know the model for this one. So if you are gonna do this with the MacBook M1, you will need an adapter. It's called the Xebec Tri-Screen Adapter. Let's get started, cheers. That I know that I searched this so I know you guys are gonna be searching it. So, you know what, I'm gonna do my best here, okay? Oh, pretty light. I would say it's maybe like 2 pounds, 3 pounds at the most. It's pretty light. So like if you need to carry it around anywhere, that's good. And then here's like the instructions. We will figure out what this is for. Let's go. So here's the product. So it says to open it like this, and that's how you attach it to your laptop. I'm holding it upside down. But these corners here should go on the outside, like the border of your laptop. So I'll show you. Pull it apart like this and attach it right here. And so again, so the first time I did this, it didn't align. So we're gonna align these corners here. Now this is one drawback I'll say. It is pretty, like if your screen bends back all the way, it will fall back. But the nice thing is that the Xebec comes with these little like, what are these called? I guess stands, so that it doesn't do that. So, and then I believe you just pull them out. And there are your screens. Look how lovely. Oh, 3 screens. And it's all leveled, which is amazing. It bends, and dude, what? It bends outward too. Hi, Steph from the future. So very quickly I realized that maybe filming something that you've never reviewed before and you don't know how to put together, is not such a great idea. Instead of going through how I set it up, what is this? There you go, much better. I'm refilming some parts for you because it was a freaking disaster, okay? I'm gonna go through how I connected everything, and then also I'm gonna go through what went wrong and what issues I had and how to fix them if there is a fix for them. So don't skip, because there's gonna be a lot of stuff that came up along the way. There might be some clipbacks from the like original. You're gonna have to ignore the lighting changes. I'm so sorry. Hey, okay, setting up the PC. So remember that big packet of cables? They gave us a bunch of cables and they gave you a bunch of like extensions. Okay, they give you more than you need. So I was really confused. I was like, I don't think we need all of this. You don't need all of it. Pretty much each screen needs a power source and a video source, okay? So when I looked at the when I looked at the pictures of the Xebec on like their ads or whatever, it only had one cable connecting to each screen. And so when I connected it on the left side, it worked. And on the right side, for whatever reason, I needed 2 cables. I figured it out. It's because on the left side of my laptop, I have a USB-C right here, okay? So that's where I'm plugging one of them into the left side. And that one works perfectly. It like automatically turns on, okay? And now on the right side, I just have a regular USB. I guess that doesn't give it power. I don't know, one of the two. It gives it power or video or whatever. But anyway, point being, I need to use 2 cables for this side. So I need to use the HDMI and the USB. But you're gonna be like, oh my God, Steph, but like, these are both USB-C like connectors. Okay, they gave us the adapters. Look at us, we're figuring it out. Because I know I have to do that, I'm gonna, this is a USB-C adapter connecting to the regular USB, all right? So I'm gonna connect that here. Okay, perfect. And this is the other USB-C. Both ends of the USB-C plug into the monitors directly, okay? So I'm gonna plug that in and I'll just show you the end result, because honestly, like, give me a break, I'm struggling. Okay, so now I've plugged this USB-C to USB-C and then this USB-C to USB-C, okay? Okay, so plugging in. This is really hard to do. I probably should have stood my camera up. But anyway, you get it. Plug it in. Click it, make sure it clicks. And then the screen should turn on.
Okay, now you're gonna do the same thing with the other side, and you'll see the screen go blank because it's like processing or whatever doing this thing. So you're gonna do the same thing with this side. Make sure it clicks, and same thing, screen will come up. Now it's gonna be blank because on this side, I guess if it's not like the USB-C that's like the charger kind, oh my God, I'm butchering this, then it won't like actually power it. So we have to use an HDMI, which my computer has. Every computer is gonna be different. If you look on the website, it'll tell you. And then the other side of it's a mini HDMI. So this cable we will plug in. Oh my God, doing this with one hand is kind of crazy, okay. And then I'm gonna plug this in here. It's really hard to do with holding the camera, so hang on. So I have plugged it in and it is all set up and ready to go. So look guys, this thing, okay. So I've been using this for 4 months and when I tell you my productivity has shot up, look at this. Look at this, three screens, baby. Portable, it collapses. It literally, like you can unplug it, fold it in, put it in your backpack. This thing is 2 pounds and it's compatible with Mac, literally. One of the only reasons I bought it, it was because it was compatible with Mac and PC. So, tutorial on the Mac coming in a second, or like review, whatever you wanna call it. I do wanna note that when I first got the laptop, I had an issue with one of the screens going blank and saying no signal. And it would just be out of nowhere. Like it would be working and then it wouldn't work and then it would work. And come to find out, I had a faulty cable. So if that's happening to you, I mean, I doubt, that's probably like one in a million, but like if that's happening to you after it already was working fine, it might be the cable. So try to switch the cables. And then if you figure out that it is the cable, you know, call them. And they were actually really nice. They sent me a replacement for free. They sent me multiple replacements for free. Not saying they will do that for you, but that's what they did for me. Hey, shout out to Beck. Okay, and before we leave, I also was having issues with sound. I'll clip that in here, how I fixed it.
I figured I'd mess with the settings a little bit. We'll go youtube.com. It's the same video as last time. Again, volume all the way up. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna type sound into the search bar. Okay, and we're gonna go into sound settings here. Now, all I did was change this to this. And the sound starts working. Solution provided. Okay, great, bye.
What else was it gonna say? Some other little features I'm gonna like clip in here, okay?
Sorry, my camera died, but I did wanna show you that you are able to move everything over to all three screens and you are able to adjust the size, the color of the screen, like the brightness, you are able to adjust that with these buttons up top up here. I think I showed that a little bit earlier in the video. They have like settings on the monitor. Let's see if it focus. So you can do all these settings, you can change it all just by like pressing these little buttons up top. I honestly, guys, I'm really obsessed with this. Like my productivity has gone up for sure.
Okay, and we're back, cheers. Been a while. So now we're gonna try this with the MacBook M1. Okay, hello, I've already attached the screens. Okay, you guys already know how to do that. Open the laptop, I've installed the software, okay? When the thing comes, it tells you how to install the software. It comes with a little like QR code. And actually this is it, right here. It's on the back of this. Quick disclaimer, I did have to call them because at first it wasn't working for me. And so there's a little step that I included in video at the end of this little portion right here that will help you do that, okay?
See these two little, I don't know if you can see it, it's like two little squares, right? So you click that and you wanna make sure that this is checked off. Mine was not checked off. So it says launch app automatically after logging in.
Right here, it's on the back of this. And so this is the Xebec tri-screen adapter. And now what comes in it will be this guy and this little attachment, all right? I already hooked it up together. You're gonna attach this little guy, USB-C, whatever thing, and you know how your Mac, or my Mac, has two little things, and that's like literally the only thing you can plug into onto this laptop. We're gonna plug this
in here. There's two other ends, and it's gonna be a mini HDMI and another USB-C looking thinger. And those will plug directly into this screen here, okay? So I'm gonna plug those in. I need two hands, hang on. There you go, turned on. Okay, great. And then we're gonna plug.
Okay, now remember how the Xebec came with like a bunch of cables and attachments, so like you might need these cables, you might not. For the Mac, you're gonna need two more cables.
All right, and this is what worked for me. I am not a tech guru expert, but I needed a USB-C to USB-C cable. So that's one cable. And then I needed another USB-C. And again, this all comes with the Xebec. And a female USB-C. That's a female, right? Yeah, that would make sense. And then you're gonna plug the male into the female. How old are we? And then now you have one cable.
You can use just the USB-C to USB-C, but for me, I found that it really like constricted the screens, like the cable wasn't long enough for me to be able to like extend the screen fully, and that really bothered me. So I used the extension. So now we're gonna plug it in, okay, to the laptop.
You're gonna plug the other end in to that side. Ta-da! Beautiful, 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 beautiful. Okay, so now I haven't actually done this step yet. I just know that the monitors work. I don't really need this tri-screen on my laptop, but I just wanted to make sure. I wanted to make sure that it worked, okay? But we're gonna go to the little Apple thing, system preferences. Then we're gonna go to displays. And we're gonna go to arrangement. And then this will tell you which screen is which. So this highlighted one, and if I click two, we see the little red thingy. It's gonna highlight that screen too. Highlights that one as two, and then three, okay, you get it. And then I'm gonna click gather windows. Did that work? Yeah, buddy! Let's open Safari, and look! We're just some bright little cookies, aren't we? All three screens, baby. All three screens. Whatever, you get it. It's here.
Okay, cheers, because that was crazy. For me, it was crazy. Y'all probably just like chilling, but okay, final takeaways. I don't even know like how to express how happy I am that I freaking purchased this thing. Dead ass. My productivity has skyrocketed. If you travel, if you work from home, you can move to any room in your house. You don't have to bring multiple monitors, and it's 2 pounds. Do you know how often I've stressed like carrying monitors and like having to, when I travel, like go home for the one, I have to buy a monitor, then return it, you know, after the holidays are over? Just kidding, I never said I did that, but I kind of did, but I didn't. Like if you're constantly minimizing, maximizing, I can't express to you how much time this thing has saved me. I really feel like I was the right person to do this review because I am not tech savvy, and like if I came across these issues, other people are gonna come across these issues. And there's such, like if you can fix it, once you fix it, this thing is like, I rushed on posting this because I'm like, okay, I know people are thinking about last minute Christmas gifts, and this is the freaking gift. I'm telling you, this is the gift. This is the gift. All right, man, I hope I upload this in time for you guys to order it. But like, if you've forgotten to get someone a gift, this is the freaking gift. Like, it doesn't need to be plugged into the wall. It's okay, I don't know, whatever. I'm just gonna, anyways, if you guys wanna check them out, link is in the description. If you have something like a better product or like a suggestion, let me know, because I'm actually curious. I've been looking for something like this forever, and I don't know how it just came up on an Instagram for me, but it did. I will be doing a review of the desk view, which if you don't know is the it's so cool. I'm really big into home setups. A desk, it's a clear desk that you can mount to your window and you can work from anywhere. It's so cool. Love you. If this helped, please leave a comment, like, consider subscribing, turn notifications on, because I swear, like, nobody knows when I post things. Love you. Bye. Cheers.